Welcome back to the channel. So welcome to another care and husbandry video for the Monocentropus balfouri, the sculpture island boo boo boo. So as always, if you're new to the channel, welcome. This is Kaale Trenches. This is where I do rehousing, unboxing and care and husbandry videos on tarantulas. So if you're into any of that content, subscribe if you want to. So with that said, let's get on with this care and husbandry video for the Monocentropus balfouri. So starting this off, I'm going to be talking about the top five things about this tarantula. So starting off, this is an old world. So you do have to give these guys a bit of respect because they can be a bit more defensive and a bit more quicker than new world tarantulas. So yeah, just make sure you're careful when you are dealing with these tarantulas. Second of all, these are heavy webbers. So they do make some awesome webbing, especially if you got them in a communal. Thirdly, these are a communal tarantula, as I was saying just a minute ago. So communal means that more than one tarantula can live together. So yeah, these are in a communal tarantula. Next, these reach to about 5 inches in leg span, so a decent size tarantula. And lastly, these make good old world beginner tarantulas. So if you want to keep your old world tarantulas and you're not sure what to get first, I would recommend getting the balfouri because these make awesome tarantulas. Like I said, they pretty much have everything about them. They got the looks with the nice blue and white look. They're heavy webbers, so you put them in a nice glass enclosure, they will most likely web that up and make it look pretty cool. And yeah, that pretty much sums up the balfouri. So I would recommend them to a beginner who is looking for their first old world tarantula. So let's start this off about talking about the balfouri. So this is pretty much gonna sound what I just said a minute ago. So the balfouri is most likely the most popular tarantula in the hobby, with its bright blue colours on the legs and the light brown tan colour on the abdomen and on the legs as well, as you can see from the pictures. So this is definitely one of the best looking tarantulas in the hobby, in my opinion. So the Monocentropus balfouri comes from Sculpture Island off the east coast of Yemen, I think I said that right, and most likely be found in their burrows underground. Next, I'm going to talk about the communals. So this is something that's also cool to see about this tarantula, is that they can live in a communal. So that means that they can live together, so more than one tarantula can live in the same enclosure, and that also gives them their popularity in the hobby because people want communals, I believe. So there's a lot of channels out there who keep these in a communal, and as I said before, when you keep them in a nice enclosure, they will web, they'll enough web the whole thing up. So yeah, so if you keep these in a communal, then that is awesome. I don't have a communal yet, but that is something I'm hoping to do in the future. Next is growth rate and lifespan. So the growth rate of these guys, I would say, is a slow to medium. And the lifespan, females will live to 12 years and males will live much shorter, probably about 3 or 4 years. And a female can reach to about 5 inches, males reaching slightly smaller. Now we're going to be moving on to old world and experience. So the Sculpture Island blue baboon is an old world tarantula, so they are more quicker and a bit more, they will have more stronger venom compared to a new world tarantula. So again, not good for a first time owner who's new to the hobby, but I would recommend them to a first time old world keeper. So if you want to get your first old world, I would recommend a balfouri, especially if you've got good confidence when you're dealing with your spiders. So if you're not very nervous and stuff like that, then I would definitely highly recommend a balfouri in your collection. Now we are on price. So here in the UK, I think I've seen slings go for about £14, juveniles for about £35, adults probably say near enough the same as my other ones, £50, between £50 and £100. Obviously females costing more, no matter what the size is. If it's a female, it's going to cost more than an unsexed dredgler, so keep that in mind. The reason why females sell for more is because everyone wants a female, so that's why they cost more than unsexed and males. Now we are on temperature and humidity. So my room sits between 20 and 24 degrees, and humidity I keep it between 60 and 70%, and that would be more than enough to keep your balfouri happy. So for the last topic, we're now going to be talking about enclosures. So before I say anything else, I'll put a picture on screen of what enclosures I'm talking about, so you can see what they look like. So starting off with slings, I keep my slings in sling pots or the sling boxes. Juveniles, I put them into the plastic Braplast tubs, or I'll put them in the cricket boxes, what your crickets arrive in or what you buy your crickets in. Then once they outgrown them, I will put them in a 15 by 15 by 21 centimeter cube enclosure, which I've recently just done. I'll leave a link in the description below, so if you want to see that rehousing. And then once they outgrown that, then they'll most likely get moved up to a 30 by 30 by 30 centimeter cube enclosure, or you know, 30 by 30 by 30 enclosure, and that'll be more than enough to keep that tarantula in for the rest of its life. Obviously if you keep a communal, then I think you might want something bigger, but because I don't keep a communal, then I'm not gonna talk about enclosure sizes for a communal. So that's the enclosures. Now I'm just gonna talk about what you can put in your enclosures. So obviously you can do your basic setups, which are just your substrate, your pieces of cork bark, your fake plants, your moss and stuff like that. Or you can do your bioactive enclosures, which is the same thing, but you use your live plants. I've done a bioactive enclosure on my channel already, so again I'll link that down below if you want to check that out. I did one for my poecilotheria miranda, the Bengal ornamental, so if you want to check that out, I'll leave a link down below. Also, I just want to make a quick note as well, if you get a balfouri and it's your first balfouri, always have in mind that it might not web as much as you may think. Some balfouri won't web loads, like where it's like really heavy webbing. Some of them might just lay a mat or just do a tiny bit. So always have in mind that it might not web as much as you think it might do, if that makes sense. So some balfouris web, some don't, and some web a lot. So always have that in mind when you get your balfouri. So I think that covers everything. So hopefully you enjoyed this care and husbandry video for the Monocentropus balfouri. If you liked it, leave a comment down below, let me know what you think. So if you liked this video, give it a like. If you didn't, leave a dislike. I do just want your opinions. Like I said, drop a comment down below, hit the subscribe, hit the share, and hopefully I'll see you again next time. Bye for now.